So in today's lecture, EE352 power system, we'll discuss about the single line diagram. So what is single line diagram? What is the use of single line diagram? So a one line or single line diagram of power system shows the main connections and arrangement of components. So why it is required to draw a single line diagram of say a substation, power system or a transmission line? The reason is it gives a convenient practical way of network representation rather than drawing the actual three-phase diagram, which may need be quite cumbersome and confusing for a special practical size power network. Let's say example, if you draw a power system. So when I say power system, so it is a combination of generation, transmission and distribution. So by representing a single line diagram, I can represent it like this. This will represent the generation or generator. Here I am representing a step of transformer, which is used for increasing the voltage level of generating station. Say the generated voltage is 11 kV and I generate it from 11 kV to say 220 kV. So in place of actual transformer, a figure of three phase power transformer, I'm just drawing a symbolic representation of that particular transformer. So an electrical engineer will easily understand that this is the generator having a generated voltage of 11 kV. This is a step of transformer which is connected through the generator and it is used for increasing the voltage level from 11 kV to 220 kV. And this is a bus bar. And this is bus bar, and this is a transmission line. This is representing the transmission line, and at this end, by putting one more transformer and say here I am representing the load as a motor. This is another transformer, say 220/11 kV, which is a step down transformer, and the motor is representing as a load. So this is a single line diagram of a power system. This block representing the generation or generator section. This will represent the from here to here. This is representing the generation. Say from here to here, this is the transmission section, the generation section, and this will be the distribution section. So this is the main advantage of per unit system, single line diagram of representing power system using single line diagram. Now I'll draw one line diagram, single line diagram of a power system which consists of two generators and n number of loads. See, this is generator 1, generator 2 having a power capacity of say 100 MVA. This is the apparent power. And the voltage rating is of 11 kV. This is the representation of circuit breaker, which is a protective device which is connected to the relay. This is transformer, say for the convenience I am taking the voltage level of 220 kV. 11 kV is a step up to 220 kV. So this is also 11 of the 220 kV. This is a bus bar. All the generators are connected through this bus bar, and this is a transmission line of say we'll say that a 500 kilometer transmission line. At this is the sending end, and at the receiving end we have a bus bar where different feeders are connected to this bus bar. This is a 220 kV primary, say 132 kV, 220 kV, 132 kV, 220 kV, 132 kV. So at the receiving end I am step down the voltage from 220 kV to 132 kV. Now this 132 kV will send to another location where a substation is situated. Say the distance between these will be 100 km. Here this 132 kV will step down to say 33 kV. And this 33 kV will send to the distributor section, where once again it will convert into 33 of with 11 kV, and this 11 kV is once again converted to 11.4 kV, and this will send it to the load. By this way this feeder is also supplying the load. So this is a representation of an actual power system which is having two generators. Generator 1 having the capacity of generator is 100 MVA, 11 kV voltage rating. Here the voltage is step up to 220 kV, then it is transferred over a long distance transmission line of say 500 km, and at the load side this 220 kV is first stepped down to 132 kV with the help of a step down transformer. Then this 132 kV once again traveled to a distance which is smaller than the previous distance, and at the nearer to the load center this will 132 kV will once again step down to 33 kV. And as you see these loads are residential load, are say domestic load which requires a 3 phase 440 volt supply or single phase supply. So this 33 kV once again step down to 11 kV, and then it will step down to 11.4. Here if a customer wants 3 phase supply of 0.4 kV, then 3-phase supply is given to him. Or if he wants single-phase supply, a phase and neutral connection is given to the domestic customer. Say one more thing we can draw here. For example, at this feeder, industrial load is connected. So 220 kV is converted into 132 kV. Here 132 is converted into 33 kV, and say if the industry demands, so it will give to the particular industrial load. So if we draw the actual circuit in place of the single line diagram of the entire network, of this entire power system network, then you can imagine that by placing the actual figure of generator, transformer, circuit breaker, transmission line and the load, it is very the size of the diagram will be much more larger, and also it will be complicated to understand. But by this way, electrical engineer or who are dealing with the power system or electrical engineering very well understand that how the power is flowing from the generating station to the load center. Now one more thing is there, why the power is being transmitted at such a higher level, say 220 kV or 400 kV or more than that. The reason is to reduce the transmission losses, because as the voltage level increases, the current level will decrease with the same ratio, and the losses in transmission, that is I square R losses, will be less. The transmission losses are I square R losses will be less. That's why we transfer or transmit the power, electrical power, over such a high voltage range. So this is the single line diagram of a power system. These are, it actually consists the symbolic representation of electrical equipment. Say this is the generating station or generator, circuit breaker, transformer, bus bar, transmission line, say this will be the load. Here we can also representing the load by motor or RL load, RLC load. Now one more thing, the representation of the power system in with the help of impedance diagram. So this is the simple single line diagram. Now we will study about the impedance diagram. For that, before drawing the impedance diagram of a system, power system, I'll draw the power system diagram or single line diagram of power system. See, this is a single line diagram of simple power system, which consists of a generator, and this connected to a bus bar, which is also connected to a load. Say the transformer is representing by number 1 and the load is representing by A. The cross is representing the circuit breaker. As you know, this is the representation of transformer. This star with neutral star with the star point is connected to ground, representing that the transformer primary and secondary both are star connected with the neutral grounded. This is the transmission line. This is the receiving sending end section, and this will be the receiving end section. At receiving end, a step down transformer is there, which is having primary star connected with star point, a common point grounded, and the secondary is of delta connected. Connected to a bus bar which is having three different types of load. First, I'll draw, then I'll explain what actually we are drawing. Transformer T1, This is the representation of transmission line. This is the representation of transmission line. So this is generator 1, impedance diagram generator 1, load A which is representing the RL load, transformer 1. This is the primary winding, secondary winding, and these are the impedance and resistance of transformer. So we can make it closer to the winding. This is representing a transmission line consisting of resistance and inductance. This, once again, we are representing the transformer, primary side, secondary side, and here I am connecting the two generators and a load. So first I will connect the load. This is transformer. Transformer T2. This is transformer T2. Then as the load is, we assume that RL nature. So this is the load B. This is the load B, and then the two generators. See, generator 2, generator 3. Generator 2 and this is generator 3. So this is the impedance diagram I am right here. This is the impedance diagram of simple power system. This is the single line diagram of the simple power system, and this is the impedance diagram. In this impedance diagram, I'll show you the generator section is representing by this particular impedance, which is having a generated EMF, resistance and inductance. Then load we have taken as RL load, which is representing like this. Then transformer is having, one more thing we have to draw. Here we also have to draw the resistance and inductance. This is the primary winding, secondary winding. These are the impedance of transformer T1. Transmission line is representing by RL load. Then same as transformer T2, this is load B, generator 2 and generator 3. So, what is the need of impedance diagram? Or say, why we have to draw the impedance diagram? Because with the help of single line diagram, we can understand the functioning of a system, say power system, easily and conveniently. But with the help of this impedance diagram, we can analyze the system very easily as compared with the actual system diagram. So that is the purpose of impedance diagram. By this way we can convert any power system diagram into impedance diagram. First we will convert into single line diagram, or directly we can draw the impedance diagram. Now you can see here we draw a single phase impedance diagram. The system, this power system is three phase power system, but here we draw a single phase impedance diagram of this simple power system, because we assume that the system is in balanced condition. So we have to analyze a single phase, and the same thing will happen to another second and third phase. So that is why we draw here impedance diagram in single phase.